Kwangson at this network last night. He is moving on to other things. In the weeks ahead, the 7 p.m. Eastern hour on CNN will be devoted to something you, Wolf, and I care a lot about, many of our viewers, politics. So our colleague John King will be taking over in the anchor seat in that hour. But for tonight, we know the hardest working man in the news biz will be filling in for another hour. Yes, Wolf, viewers will be seeing more of you tonight. I don't know how you keep going. I hope they're giving you an energy drink.
Just one more hour, 4 hours is not too bad. We've done more before. Jessica, thanks very much. We wish Lou Dobbs all the best. Lou, an original CNN anchor going back to 1980. He's moving on, and we wish him good luck. A beauty queen threatens to walk out on Larry King Live. One of many most unusual, awkward moments on TV lately. Here's our Jeanne Moos.
We never turn up our nose for news.
This is disgusting, I know.
Especially not at those wonderfully awkward moments.
Larry, you're being inappropriate. You really are. So I'm not going to talk about
it. I'm asking a question.
We screwed up.
This week had more than its share of awkward TV moments, thanks to the former Miss California, USA. Maybe you saw her getting miffed at Larry King and taking off her mic.
Is she leaving? Because I asked what motivated the settlement. Did you hear the question?
No, I can't hear you.
But I'm answering what I can't hear.
And I'm about to leave your show.
Who are you talking to? Hello?
But we crowned Carrie Prejean Miss Awkward Moment because she inspired awkward moments on more than one show.
And yet you say that you're a victim. I don't totally buy it.
Did you see the attacks that I was under?
It's the best thing that happened to you.
I'm not worried about you, Carrie.
But our favorite awkward moment was Barbara Walters describing Prejean's X-rated home movie.
You alone, doing whatever you were doing with yourself.
What was Sean Hannity doing on Fox News, Jon Stewart wondered, using video of a major rally 2 months ago to illustrate a smaller protest against health care reform.
Not a cloud in the sky, the leaves have changed. All of a sudden, the trees turn green again, and it's cloudy.
Trying to make the smaller rally seem bigger, said Stewart. Inadvertent mistake, said Hannity, but he apologized.
So, Mr. Stewart, you were right. I want to thank you and all your writers for watching.
CNN's Situation Room went to pot this week.
So, Wolf, would you know a marijuana plant if you saw one?
I'm not sure I would know. I could smell it. You could smell a marijuana, Lou, but you probably wouldn't recognize a plant. Am I right or wrong?
Well, you're dead wrong.
Certitude plus attitude. What a dude. Lou, we're going to miss you.
This will be my last broadcast here on CNN.
From veteran leaving to cub arriving, the Today Show announced the winner of its Kid Reporter competition.
Deirdre Shores. It's you. Deirdre, it's you.
It's you,
Deirdre. It's you.
You're the winner. You're today's Kid Show Kid Reporter winner. You're the winner, Deirdre.
If you're going to be a reporter, kid, you got to learn to fill dead air. We said fill it, not kill it. Jeanne Moos, CNN, New York.
You just broke my eardrum.
And happening now, a new move by the federal government targeting properties linked to Iran, including several mosques here in the United States. This hour, the breaking news on a major counterterrorism investigation. And early doubts about the alleged Fort Hood gunman's state of mind. We're learning more about his colleagues' deep concerns about a man now charged with murder. And a frightening milestone in the swine flu epidemic. We're going to take you behind the scenes, the dramatic rise in the death toll. I'm Wolf Blitzer in CNN's Command Center for breaking news, politics, and extraordinary reports from around the world. You're in the Situation Room. But we're continuing to follow our breaking story this hour involving the U.S. government's takeover of an office tower and several mosques here in the United States. Federal prosecutors are investigating a nonprofit Muslim organization suspected of transferring money to the Iranian government and the properties they own. Let's go to CNN's Deborah Farrick. She's in New York. She's picking up the story for us. All right, Deborah, what's going on?
Well, Wolf, here's what we've got. U.S. officials are attempting to seize four mosques plus a New York City skyscraper just steps from Rockefeller Center on Manhattan's Fifth Avenue. The charge that the Alavi Corporation, which gets money from these properties, is actually a front company for a larger Iranian-owned bank, and that that bank channels money to support Iran's nuclear program and parts of its military forces labeled terrorist organizations by the United States. Now, the four mosques include the Islamic Institute of New York in Queens, New York, the Islamic Education Education Center in Houston, Texas, which is what you're looking at right now, and two other mosques in Maryland and California. The imam at the New York mosque is on a pilgrimage to Mecca and could not be reached for comment.